I was more afraid of the whole situation than excited, because America's a new place, and I walked into my room and both of my roommates were sleeping, and it was just really new to me, and I was just really scared.
When I first came to Culver, I was really nervous that I wasn't gonna make friends, and I was really nervous because I was also one of the only rooms that had two roommates. So my first thought was, not only am I gonna have to be nice to one girl, I'm gonna have to be nice to two girls and try to balance that whole out. But I was really excited, and when I met them, I knew right away that that year was gonna be one of my favorite years at Culver.
Honestly, I was pretty terrified my first day. I thought I was gonna have no friends and like it was gonna be horrible. And I got here, my first day was sports week, and I came in expecting to have a roommate and be like best friends with my roommate, and then all of a sudden my counselor, Ms. Fulton, walks me in and she goes, "By the way, your roommate's not going to be here for another week, so just be prepared for that." So that was pretty rough, but I mean, I had an amazing big sis, Emily Rich. She was there to help me through my first day and everything. So I mean, after being terrified, I went through all my classes and then I came back, and it was nice to have my big sister to help.
My first day, I was so excited. I was a little puppy freshman. I was so excited to come in. I had an international roommate, so I was like excited to meet her because I didn't know anything like about her beforehand. I remember not knowing where Benson was. They said, "You're in Benson." I go, "Okay, where's that?" And they were like, "Oh, you know, the white building's way off on campus." I don't know, Benson just kind of found me, I guess. I just remember all the seniors coming to my room, welcoming me. I could not place a name to a face or a room number to anyone, but it was just such a whirlwind and so fun, and I don't know, that's just really what I remember. It was a blur.
When I made the cheerleading team at Culver, I was really excited because I was super introverted for my first 2 years at Culver, and so I was excited to branch out and meet new people. And coming into senior year, making the team again, I was really excited because I knew I was gonna become really close friends with all the other seniors on the team.
You know, I don't have like a fun like memory, like that one memory. They're just like a bunch of little things, like from running around in the halls, like late night shenanigans, like with all my like friends, Emily, Bree, and Erica, like from getting shower partied freshman year for my birthday, to taping Bree to a chair and like leaving her in front of someone's door for the night and having to clean up the scratches on the floor. Like, I don't know, just like the late night stuff that we would all just do. Like, those are just the best memories that you have. It's the stuff that you remember. And it's not just one big memory, but all the little ones that really count and make them up.
Especially toward the end of the year, past like 2 years or so, like Katie, Taylor, and I just like sleep in Katie and Taylor's room. Like, even maybe when we're not supposed to, but yeah, we would just spend the night there. We'd be up so late talking. It was just like I'll never forget those nights when we like read Kazo or something. Like,
definitely, there was this one night. I think it was Inga. She was a German exchange student my sophomore year here, and the people, her homestay parents, brought a ton of marshmallows and like chocolate fondue stuff and a ton of food. And the whole dorm was there, like, laughing and having jokes and everything, and it was a lot of fun. And then my future roommate and I went and took, like, a ton of chocolate and basically, like, threw it at each other. It was, like, this massive food fight, and it was just, like, this great memory from my first year here.
I think what I love about Culver so much is that there's just small things that no one else gets. So like the pillow fight, like no one else understands that. Just like all the small things that you can say about Culver and no one will get. That's what I love about it, is being able to talk to someone and they actually get Culver.
Culver's special because I feel like anyone from anywhere can come here and succeed and do well as long as they do their best. All the people that make it so diverse and make it what it truly is, it's amazing. It's without us, without the sense of community, Culver wouldn't be what it is. I really can't imagine my experience without everyone that I've met here.
The people at Culver, the relationships that you make here are relationships that you won't be able to find anywhere else. Even like at home and going off to college, like I don't think I'll have as good of friends as I've made here in my 3 years.
It's truly a community. And coming from a school of 4,500, New Trier just doesn't ever have that feeling. It's always cutthroat and it's always, oh, I better beat her or else I won't get recognized. But here, like, when I achieve something, Peyton's happy for me and a bunch of other girls who I know are happy for me, even if it's maybe not them getting it and vice versa. I'm happy for them when they achieve something that maybe they deserved it more than I did. And so I think that's just what makes Culver really unique and special.
Definitely the people is what makes Culver special. The teachers, staff, faculty, everyone wants you to excel. They want you to do well and go places in life. And they truly care about you as a person. And just those relationships and bonds that you make with them will last a lifetime. I can picture myself coming back here and sitting down with one of my teachers because they're the ones that wanted to see me do well and go somewhere in life. And that's really what makes Culver special.
I really think that, you know, it was my counselor, Ms. Fulton. Although we had our ups and downs, she was the one who actually was straightforward with me and saying, Arisa, you need to get your act together and just start working, or you need to, you know, get these stuff done. She would take me like out to dinners or like shopping malls when I'm like by myself in my room over long weekends. And she was the, I guess, the person who's kind of a mentor figure to me.
Definitely my dad. Since he's a counselor here, he kind of gave me the 411 before I entered, and it was completely different on the guy side. But whenever I need anything, he's always there. Whenever I don't know what's going on, I can send him a text and he'll be like, this is what it means, this is what happened. And he just gives me that sense of comfortability when I don't know what's going on.
Definitely all the girls in the dorm have really been there for me whenever I needed them. My roommate especially. I come here and this room, it's definitely my home. I come here and I can be myself, and my roommate's there, Katie Willis. She has definitely helped me through everything here.
Anna has been a really big help to me this year, just because she kind of, even though I'm older than her, it's just kind of funny because she is kind of sometimes like my mom here. Hannah just brings so much energy always. Mindy last year could always make me laugh. Arisa, I always go to her for academic advice. Peyton is just, I mean, she has been like my lifesaver this year. She really has been. I would not have traded any roommate in the world for her. I mean, I have no idea what I'm going to do at Northeastern next year without her.
I wouldn't say that I have one specific person, but I think mostly just my peers. Again, like going off of how close we all are, we're able to go get help from one another. If I need help in a certain area here, I can go to one person and another person over there. I just think that it means a lot to be able to go to everyone and get bits and pieces.
Sleda Dodge, Patience Durbin, they were always there for me when I needed a hug or somebody to cry with, and my mom got me through a lot too.
The person who influenced me the most was Emily Rich. She was a junior when I was a freshman. She was my hall prefect my first rotation freshman year. We played volleyball, varsity together. I don't know, she just kind of like took me in under her wing. It was kind of random, but it wasn't. But she literally was there for me every step of the way. Every step of the way. You know, all my big moments, you know, making a team, getting a good grade, getting a good test. She crested me. She was my big sister. She rang me. She was there for me for everything. She always knew what to say at the right time. She really helped me survive Culver.
Chandler Corey, she's like my, I just loved her, adored her. She like always had the best advice. I was always so down to earth, and she's like, Erica, you just gotta do this, and she's really pushed me to try new things.
Taught me so much to kind of be more aware of myself and how to work with other people, and I think that is a necessary skill for life, because in the real world you're gonna have to suck it up and work with people you don't like. I think Culver's taught me that, as well as leadership and what my strengths are and how to be aware if I am overusing it or pushing it a little too far.
I look different, and I'm definitely more outspoken. I feel like I've found my voice, and I'm not an echo anymore.
Culver has definitely made me more mature. I think I was pretty mature coming in since I was an only child, and my parents were older, so they always like pushed me out of the house, you know, want me to do things on my own. But Culver has definitely let me kind of take the reins on things that I want to do. If I want to do a certain thing in a leadership position, Culver has taught me to just go and do it. Don't wait for anyone to tell me yes. You know, my life or what I do is what I make of it. And before, I'm not really sure if I would have pushed so much to do something or do a certain thing. And now, if like I want to accomplish something or I want to help someone, I'm going to do it no matter what.
When I first came to Culver, I was super bubbly and outgoing in a nervous wreck, basically. But now, leaving senior year, I feel really confident, and I feel like I actually know what I want to do, and I feel like I know how to get things done a lot more than I did when I first came here.
Back home, like, I always did things like definitely like within my comfort zone and like taking risks or like just like putting myself out there. And here at Culver, like, I put myself, like, I've tried new things, like sailing was something I never could do back home, so I tried it here, fell in love with it. A lot of different leadership roles, like even ones that I didn't really see myself in, I took the risk, tried hard, and it's all like really paid off. I've just been able to try so many new things and just like really put myself out of my comfort zone, which has like been something I couldn't do before I came.
People, my friends, the horses, the barn, mostly the people though.
I'm gonna miss my friends, and gosh, you're making me emotional. I'm gonna miss everything about Culver actually, because it just became a part of me now, and now I have to leave and start a new life in college. I'll definitely miss all my friends, all my classes, all my teachers, and just the fact that, you know, I can run around the dorm and scream and no one yells at me, and we can just have fun together like that, and all the fun times that I had with my friends, like all the crazy things that we did.
I'll definitely miss my seniors in the dorm, because whenever I can't go out or whenever I'm in need of something or I have a question, I don't run to my dad anymore, I run to them, and especially my roommate Claire, because in the past my roommates have been kind of up and down experiences, but with Claire it's been kind of solid and we really get each other, and it's just gonna be really sad leaving her next year. And
I'm really gonna miss the dorm. I mean, I know that I talked to seniors who graduated last year and they live in their dorms and they're like, it's nothing like Benson.
Late night conversations, hang out, like outside, we'd like do tanning Sundays, Taylor, Katie, and I.
I'll definitely miss the people the most. All the friends that I made. Our relationships are just gonna last forever. And they're ones that, like, you know, our bonds are never gonna break. We're always gonna be friends. We're always gonna be the Breakfast Club. Like, we're always gonna be there for each other. And of course I'm gonna miss Culver, but it's just gonna be the people and just being with each other 24/7. I'm gonna miss my roommate. Oh man.
Don't wait.
live in the moment, go out and do crazy things, play games around campus. Don't just stay in your room. Go out and live Culver, because you only get Culver for a little bit.
I know that in Asian culture, we value academics a lot, but in Culver, you need to explore. You're given opportunities to explore so many things. So don't just stay in your room and do homework and study. Do what's out there. Join more sports. You know, academics can bring you far in life, but leadership and relationships, that's what's gonna bring you farther.
Okay, my advice is go out, have fun. Don't stay in your room on Friday nights. You want to get out and you want to try new things, you know. So go out on Friday nights, go to the bonfire, make a s'more. Like, those are some memories and times that you'll never get back and you wish you would have been able to do.
Enjoy your time here and do everything that you want to do. One of my biggest regrets is not doing everything that I wanted to, or staying in my room on Friday and Saturday nights when I should have been hanging out with my friends, or at a dodgeball tournament, or at the senior bonfires. So go out and have fun.
Just really, like, take risks, put yourself out there, and just try to make the most of anything you can do here.
Just really be yourself and try to take advantage of every opportunity that Culver has to offer, and do anything that you want to do. If you want to try out for a team, try out for a team. If you want to stay in and study on Saturday nights, don't let your friends talk you into going out. Stay in and study. Don't regret anything that you do at Culver.
Thank you so very much for sacrificing everything and allowing me this great opportunity to come to Culver. I mean, it's genuinely an experience that I would have not changed for anything, no matter how many times I've complained about it.
Thank you for never letting go of this opportunity that I've had, because I know it's been really hard for you guys, even though you're like right down the road. I know there's been some really tough times, and you've still dealt with me, and you've never just not been there for me. So just thank you for giving me this opportunity, and thank you for always being there for me.
I love you, Mom and Dad. Thank you for this amazing experience. I could not have done this without you, and you have no idea how much this means to me and how much it will always mean to me.
Thank you for paying for my school fees. I know it's very expensive. Thank you for finding this place and sending me here, and I know it was a very hard decision that you guys made. I really love both of you, and when I go off to college, I guess I won't see you guys as much anymore. I hope to make you guys proud of me.
I wouldn't have ever been able to do at home. And you guys know it. You say it all the time, that this is such an opportunity that I wouldn't have been able to miss. And I just thank you for letting me come here and maybe miss some special moments that we would have had at home. But you guys are always here, and you always support me. And I want to say thank you for coming to my games. When they're so far away, you guys always come. So thank you for giving me this opportunity.
I definitely want to say thank you. Like, Culver is an opportunity that I never have dreamed of, like my 7th year, and I just bought it and made it happen. I can never like say thank you enough for that.
Thank you for supporting me. I know it's hard to see your only daughter go off to school 600 miles away, and I only see you 4 or 5 times a year, but you've been there for me through everything, and I can call you anytime, I can Skype you and start bawling, and you're just always there for me, and thank you for all of your support and love.
As a whole, I think you need to know life doesn't have to be so serious. Although you are a senior right now, everything's going so fast, you want it done, you want it right now, stop and smell the roses, because you need to take that time to, I don't want to say appreciate, but you guys do appreciate, I want to say relax, smell the roses, enjoy life, because once you get to college, anything can happen there.
To the Benson seniors, the class of 2014, know that you will be missed and that you always have a family back here at Culver. Once a Benson girl, always a Benson girl. And you will have plenty of other Culver grads out there that completely understand and know that. And that you'll always have a home here at Culver and that you're welcome back to hang out in my office. And if you ever need a place to stay in Culver, that you're always welcome to stay with me. But you definitely always have a family and a home here. And we hope to hear from you. I love hearing from our grads and knowing how they're doing and how life is treating them and just learning lessons that they've learned from Culver or things that maybe they wish they would have learned at Culver. So stay in touch. Don't be strangers. You definitely will be missed. You are the class that was very athletic and involved and on top of things. You're also the class that your sophomore proposals were bigger than any other class. Thank you, Paige, for the Benson Haunted House and other ideas that your sophomores helped bring to the table and really make Benson a successful dorm and kind of the cool dorm because we have the best fundraisers on campus.
Okay, there's one last thing I forgot. Band-aid kit, okay? You guys are going to need them. Miss Cliff, do you have a band-aid? Oh, you know I can't give you anything. Do you have something to put on a cut? No, I can't give you anything. So make sure you guys get like a little, you know, thing here. Band-aids, alcohol swabs, especially if you're in college because you never know when you're going to fall. Literally, okay? Anyways, that's it.